How's it going, folks? Tonight we're going to play with the Fogger version 4. They actually had a couple versions of this. I got the latest version. The really only major change they did, besides a little bit of the filling design, and it's internal so you don't really see it on the outside, is they did make the stove, the metal stove inside, a little bit fatter. So it actually took away a little bit of a juice capacity. But here you can see the Fogger logo. I don't know if you can see the Fogger, it says version 4. And of course you can see it on the stove there. So let's start off by taking this thing apart. It comes with a nice metal drip tip. It does have, well, a glass centerpiece. That's really nice if you're going to use your tank crackers. So let's take it apart and let's build it back up. I've been using it all day. I got about 3.5 mil of juice in it. Well, that's what I had this morning. She's empty now. Let's go ahead and take this apart. Now I've already taken the wicks out. So now we got a build deck with a couple of coils. They're not the sexiest coils, but they're efficient. They'll get the job done. So let's take our chimney. Go ahead and separate that. Now, the way this thing works on the glass piece is you have an O-ring right up in the top. See, it's got some juice all over it. Well, I've been using it, so you also got an O-ring inside there on the build deck. So that's what your glass pipe sits on. And if you look just right, you can see the 4 juice channels. Now you can stick the wick in those. I don't. I just run it just like a dual K-fun, basically. At least that's what I'm doing now. At first, I was putting wick in the juice channels. Pain in the ass, man. Just make it like a dual K-fun. That's all you need. Let's get some cotton. Let's wick this thing up. Don't know if you can hear the music in the background. That's a Pantera. I'm a metalhead, so if you don't like it, fuck off. So let's get our first piece of wick in there. Now you want this snug, but not too tight. And after you thread it through, just kind of defurl the ends a little bit. Then you want to get another piece of cotton, do the same thing. Now again, you want that kind of snug, but not too tight. Again, I like to defurl the edges a little bit. Now you could trim some of this excess off, or you can just leave it on there. I'm gonna leave a nice, healthy amount of cotton. So let's put our Fogger stove on it. Make sure you got the logo facing right so that you can see and show all your friends, hey, it's a Fogger. So let's get these wicks. Pull them up. Feed them right through that stove. Oh, another little feature that's nice on this, that knurled ring here, that's for your airflow adjustment. It does have 2 airflow inlets. One right there, one right there. So you got dual intakes. Now, we want to take and basically just separate the wicks, kind of tuck them down there some. Again, I'm building this just like it's a dual K-fun, basically. Now, you never want to fire, well, I'm using cotton, so you never want to fire it dry. Got some key lime pie. Gonna load this thing up. Well, not gonna load it up just yet, but we're gonna wet the wicks here so that we're not dry firing. Now, I always like to fire them before I completely assemble it. Do the same thing with the K-funds, just so I know everything's still working good. And I'm sorry if everything's all juicy here. You know, this is something I used today, so. There we go. Not a lot, but once I crank the watts up, she'll be putting off a lot more steam than that. So now, let's go ahead and finish the assembly. Let's put the top of our chimney on there. Put our glass. I like the fact they did that. A glass midsection, our metal top section. Go ahead and give it one more rotation. Now, this is, again, kind of juicy, and it's a black atomizer, so with the shadows, probably kind of hard to see. But let's go ahead and pop that fill screw out. And let's juice it up. She's running down the sides there. And again, people, I'm basically treating this just like a dual K-Fun. When I first got it, I followed a couple videos from YouTube, and everyone was saying go ahead and put some juice in the wick channels. And you know what? It does work. You just got to be real sparingly with the amount of wick you put in there. I found, well, after running it all day today, that it's not necessary. Just pack it in there like it's a K-Fun. If you haven't already built a K-Fun, well, I got a video for that too. I got a Russian K-Fun build video. So just get that thing just snug. You don't want to tighten it up too much. Now, let's go ahead and slap a tip on here. And let's check it. Oh, by the way, the coils I'm running, I ended up with 1 ohm. So I've essentially got two ohm coils. Now, oh man, I love some key lime pie. Yeah man, she's doing good. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is my quick, ugly, and dirty review of how I build the Fogger V4. Y'all have a good evening, and I'll catch you on the flip side.